Hello everyone and welcome. I have been driving the 2017 Volkswagen Golf All-Track and I've been quite enjoying it, but one of the things that's pretty interesting about this car, if you pop the hood and check out the engine, this is the 1.8 liter EA888 from Volkswagen. It's a turbocharged engine, and one of the really interesting things is that if you look at the turbocharger, you'll notice it's right next to the engine itself. So a very short distance in between the turbocharger and the engine block. So what does this mean? Well, what this means is that the exhaust manifold is essentially located entirely within that cylinder head. Now, why would Volkswagen do this? Well, basically what they've got going on is a water-cooled exhaust manifold, and it's a pretty cool setup. How it works is very simple. You're just looking inside the engine at the cylinders themselves. You've got the two exhaust valves dumping that exhaust out into the exhaust manifold, which is all located internally within the cylinder head. You've got coolant jackets going around that exhaust manifold, helping to cool that exhaust manifold, and then it's dumping that air into the exhaust portion of the turbocharger, spinning up the turbo, creating boost, etc. So why would you do this? Why would you put the exhaust internally in the cylinder head? Well, one of the huge benefits comes down to cold starts. So what this allows you to do is get your engine up to operating temperature very quickly. That's not only efficient, but if you need to heat the cabin, that means you're going to be able to do it sooner because you're using energy from the exhaust to help warm it up. You're also going to have less engine wear, because if your engine is cold for less duration, you're not going to have that cold startup where you don't quite have the protection that you have at operating temperature, so you can help with engine reliability by getting it up to operating temperature very quickly. Now, one of the cooler benefits of this is actually the fact that you can cool the catalytic converter. So they were able to measure the temperature difference between the exhaust gas, you know, coming out and when it's reaching that turbocharger, and they're able to cool it by 160 degrees Fahrenheit once it reaches the turbocharger. And what's neat about that is when you're at high load, you don't have to have as rich of an air fuel mixture. Typically, you're going to have an air fuel mixture that's pretty rich to reduce gas temperatures in the exhaust. And the reason you're doing that is so you don't burn up your catalytic converter. You don't want to get too hot. You do want to get it, you know, hot enough for it to be able to do its process and get rid of the harmful emissions, but you don't want it to get too hot. And so, you know, typically with turbocharged engines or just engines in general, you can run a rich air fuel mixture that will cool the exhaust gases and it won't harm your catalytic converter as much. Whereas this engine is actually going to be cooling it with the coolant jackets themselves wrapped around the exhaust manifold. As a result, Volkswagen says they are able to achieve 20% better highway fuel economy by cooling these exhaust gases and then running a leaner air fuel mixture at these higher engine loads, which is pretty neat to see that they're able to achieve. 20% is a huge number. Now, are there any disadvantages to doing this? Well, the obvious thing is that you're going to have a higher cooling load placed on the engine itself. So you're dumping a ton of heat into that engine block and you're going to have to cool that. With an engine that's only producing 170 horsepower, you know, this is a fairly low power engine, you know, relatively speaking. So the cooling load isn't that big of a problem. Certainly not something you're going to have a challenge dealing with. You know, you put a nice size radiator up front and this will be no issue. The other thing that came to mind is tunability. You know, you can't swap out the header, so to speak, and, you know, go, you know, get crazy with this. I don't think that's that big of an issue. I think companies should design their best product that they can and let the aftermarket worry about the aftermarket. But that's just something to kind of think about, is, you know, if it's all internal, then you're not going to be able to change that out. You're going to deal with the exhaust after that portion. But I think it's a pretty cool setup what Volkswagen has done. And let's just kind of check out some images of what this actually looks like. Okay, so here we can see the engine and you can see the turbocharger put right up against the engine block there. So this is the cylinder head, and as you can see, the exhaust manifold completely internal, spits right out into the turbocharger, spools that up, and you're good to go and you're creating boost. So pretty cool to see. Here's a more detailed look at the cylinder head. So you can see, you know, you've got your exhaust manifold in here that's coming out into these two ports. You know, it looks like it could be set up to support a twin squirrel turbocharger. This is a single vane turbo, but you know, you could theoretically, if you wanted to do that, since you've got these two separate exhaust ports right here. And then basically behind these, you're gonna have coolant. So you're gonna have coolant flowing in here and helping to cool that exhaust manifold. And here we have an exploded view of this 1.8 liter engine. You can see the exhaust valve right here. So your piston comes up, presses out that exhaust gases. They travel through here and then directly into the turbocharger. And then you can see in blue, is the coolant jackets that are going to be cooling this exhaust. So everything in red is the exhaust manifold where that exhaust air is coming out. And then here in blue, you can see that there is coolant jackets wrapping around that to help keep it cool. And finally, this is a low quality image, but great for seeing what this looks like internally. So you can see in red, the entire exhaust manifold wrapping around for each of the two valves at each cylinder. And then you can see the coolant water jacket for the cylinder head coming in here and wrapping around. And then you can see the exhaust manifold water jacket in the darker blue here, wrapping around, kind of, you know, curving around with the exhaust manifold itself, making sure to supply coolant to that area and cool down that exhaust manifold. So neat how they're exchanging heat here between these two, and pretty interesting design, which allows for the benefits as mentioned earlier. So pretty cool what they've done with this, and pretty neat to see such a compact exhaust manifold. So thank you guys for watching, and if you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave those below.